Nothing he could earn. It was nothing he did. And after the polling results, many of us go, wow, what just happened? I want to tell you something moving forward. Alabama is the place where ideas and people came together and changed the world. They changed the world. And we have demonstrated and showed that in times of great adversity, we can come together and forge lasting solutions. I love this song. And I think many of you are understanding more that the song that many of us will sing every day in church, or in whatever affiliation you're a part of, has a meaning that at its core is vital to who we are as a community, to who we are as an individual, and our connection to the environment. I want to say this again, because part of that unexpected innovation is the reason why I'm standing here and many of you. The ironic part is, I'm glad I did listen to my physics teacher and my music teacher, because now the world I take on in New Orleans is, guess what, after Katrina, many of these famous musicians you hear about, what an unexpected innovation. The same kind of innovation that the author and writer of the song, Amazing Grace, is now one of the most important economic centers for the entire Southeast. And guess who lies at the heart of that? It's musicians. Black, who are white, who are Hispanic, who are Creole, who are Native American, generating music, sending ripples around the rest of the world. The birthplace of America's music is right here in the Southeast. You can't get away from it. We've changed the world. And I have to take this message across the world to say that I'm from this out. Proud to be here. And unlike many others, when you speak of innovation, when you speak of uniting people with diversity, we have lived with the challenges, we have felt the scars, and we remember them. Is the place where people and ideas came together and changed. But when we have changed the world, we also must understand one key component of that song, Amazing Grace. It's about love. It's about love. When I hear many of your arguments, when I hear many of the challenges that come from the universe, when you love, it's understanding that we have to love our children more than we hate our enemies. Because what we hate. Fear the unknown. And we have to provide opportunities for everyone. Because they are part of our heritage, part of our unexpected innovation. And I'm very proud to be from Montgomery, Alabama. And it's part of that legacy and that connection to the change that I wear as a badge of honor. And it has become a most important piece of understanding and empathy. As my role of healthcare director for musicians' healthcare research, which ultimately involves the lives of these musicians who are the economic drivers who are not provided affordable healthcare. Together, we're making a difference. Because each of us have value. We're all important. It happens at many different levels. But you're all part of this. And only when we come together can we forge those lasting solutions. So I would like, normally if I were in New Orleans, I'd have this huge big choir come and jazz band, so it's stripped down, so please excuse me. But when I play the piece for you, I want you to imagine yourself as the author of that song. Would he really say, you know, Amazing Grace has come from the other side of the band, I'm really happy to be here. What was he really reflecting on? It was always a question. I once was lost, but now I'm found. I was blind, but now I see. It was a piece, really, of introspection. And then as he goes to the other verses, he really starts to tell you more about what he went through. Through dangers, fools, and snares that I already won. And he talks about death, because we all have to die to the things we really were. And in that moment that there's death, he's comforted. He's comforted, which you'll hear it in the song. You can tell it's a call and response from things that go on deep within us to a greater life of love. And then there's celebration.